Valve doesn't curate the Steam store in any way. It has literally said it's going to let everything in there from now on, pretty much no matter what. And guess what? We've got another example of why this is a bad idea.
Valve has for some years now been, let's say, a bit hands-off with what it allows and doesn't allow on its PC storefront, Steam. The amount of low-quality chaff on Steam is quite mind-boggling at this point. In 2016, about 4,207 games were added to it, about 40% of every game ever to come to Steam in 1 year. The number had risen to 7,672 games in 2017. About 130 games are added to it every single week at this point, with Valve allowing more or less anyone willing to pay $100 straight onto the storefront via its Steam Direct program. They've opted to go for an approach that highlights and promotes the quote-unquote better games while still offering a platform to everything else. And back in June, they opened the gates even wider, announcing they would allow everything from now on as long as it's not illegal or straight up trolling.
So how's this for illegal or straight up trolling? This week, several gamer news sites ran stories about Abstractism, reporting accusations that the game, which was on sale for less than a dollar on Steam, included some nasty surprises. Several players left negative reviews of the game on Steam with photographic evidence that it installs a Trojan on users' PCs, an executable called steamservice.exe, which was apparently added to the game in a patch on July 23rd. That sits cozily next to a piece of malware called Abstractismlauncher.exe. Fellow YouTube channel Sid Alpha first picked up this rather odd situation, running a full breakdown of what exactly is being accused here. We'll put a link in the description if you want to check it out. He discovered that Abstractism is apparently quietly running cryptocurrency mining software in the background. This is known as cryptojacking and could pose a serious risk for players, according to the website CSO Online. CSO Online warns it can damage computer performance, raise energy bills, and even damage cloud infrastructure. There'll also be a link to their article in the description if you want to read more about that.
Now, one of the number one signs of cryptojacking is an increase in CPU and GPU load on your system, both of which were being reported by Abstractism's players. The developer Ocarlo Union responded to negative reviews about this on Steam, saying this, quote, "Abstractism does not mine any of cryptocurrency. Probably you are playing on high graphic settings because they take a bit of CPU and GPU power required for post-processing effects rendering. This game, by the way, looks like this. It's literally described as a trivial platformer by its own developer in the first sentence of its Steam store description. So the extra GPU and CPU load has players suspicious. Then there's this. The developer posted an update on July 23rd as well, the day the patch went live, letting everyone know about how the cool new item drops added to this trivial game about jumping work. But here's where it does get a wee bit suspicious. The way that said item drops work actually encourages people to keep the trivial game running all day. That's something which would be very beneficial to any theoretical hackers who can use your machine to farm crypto all day. The item drops post also asks players to be in-game on Friday specifically to allow the drop limit to reset. And guess what? That kind of thing is another telltale sign of cryptojacking because it gives hackers time to collect hashes from the infected computers, a vital aspect of the crypto mining process. The developer even responded to one review admitting that, quote, "Bitcoin is outdated. We currently use Abstractism to mine only Monero coins," before immediately going on to say, "Abstractism does not mine any of cryptocurrency." So there's a good chance it was intended as a joke, but either way, that was swiftly deleted.
So that's the cryptojacking bit out of the way, but believe it or not, this game is accused of something else as well. Abstractism is accused of faking Team Fortress 2 Steam trading items using Team Fortress 2 text and artwork to create fake listings. One user going by the name Poor Asian Boy wrote on backpack.tf, quote, "I'm a pretty reputable and experienced trader, but geez, this one guy got me pretty good. There's a game called Abstractism on Steam where you can get an identical version of an item like the one in Team Fortress 2. They then share the screenshot, which shows just how similar the fake item is to the real deal. Anyone not paying attention could easily fail to notice the item is a fake. This guy was duped and traded away his very valuable Steam trade item and got nothing but a fake in return."
Well, once this all kicked off online, Valve did remove Abstractism from Steam, along with three companies that were associated with the game. Valve confirmed to Kotaku that it, quote, "removed Abstractism and banned its developer from Steam for shipping unauthorized code, trolling, and scamming customers with deceptive in-game items." Which is good. It's very good that Valve has acted so swiftly to remove this game. But the question kind of does remain, how the f*** did it come to this in the first place?
Three companies it took to make that game. three companies. Look at that gameplay. Yeah. Three companies.
It's, you know, it was a trivial platform, and that's true, that's what they called it. And the idea was that it was kind of an ASMR relaxing thing.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so you can relax while
it's you're
playing
so your PC
and
it's
crypto.
Yeah, that's it. We're hacking you, but they're telling you in a relaxing way, so it's okay. Damn, man, this is so dodgy. The evidence is really strong towards it being crypto jacking.
Well, there must be, I mean, Valve are convinced, obviously, because they've removed it, so.
The fact that they've got some crypto jacking software on there, and they've made the joke about it, and they've got all the telltale signs there, it's gotta be, hasn't it? It's too perfect. It's all too inconvenient for a trivial platformer that's made by three companies to not have anything dodgy going on. But this, I can imagine this is happening all the time, and it's just not getting caught out, you know what I mean? Like, I think this, I don't know how Sid Alpha got this news, but he broke this straight away.
Well, the players just started complaining about it, because there was an update on the 23rd of July.
Yeah.
And that is allegedly when this really did start picking up. But some players are actually saying that it was doing weird things before that. You know, there was like a huge demand on their GPU and CPU and stuff before this big update on July. So who knows what's going on, really. The game's been on Steam since March, by the way. And then this update came along on the 23rd of July. And then, you know, about a week, a few days later, let's say a week later, Valve does kind of removed it. Once everyone is kicked up a fuss about it online, and Sid Alpha picked it up, and then all the news websites picked it up, all the gaming news websites picked it up. And here we are talking about it, because it's just another classic example of Valve just... Valve's policy of letting everything in, you know, there's obviously going to be little bits of shit coming in as well. That's just little round pieces
of crap. All right. Steam Greenlight was... the end of the sewer, right? That's what they were saying. Well, they didn't actually.
How can you say all right and then jump straight back into fucking sewer talk, man?
Can you remember? I don't think Steam have ever on record called Steam Greenlight shit or anything, but when it.
I can imagine they did. Yeah, Revolve, we thought the Steam Greenlight was pretty shit.
Can you remember that they were talking about the bright future? And I remember when they first pitched the idea, it sounded pretty good. Everyone was looking at it, and we were like, oh, this could be a good thing. It's not changed anything, really, has it? Apart from made it that it's just a paywall to get in and put Trojans and that in there.
Literally, that's all it is. It's a $100 barrier, but as long as you're willing to pay that, you can put anything you want on there. Valve is upholding their thing here of saying, as long as it's not illegal or trolling, you know, we'll remove it. And this is clearly illegal, so they've taken it down, and trolling, you know, it's both of those boxes ticked there. But otherwise, it's letting everything in. The issue is that it's gone from one extreme to the other. Obviously, we've said this so many times before, everyone knows by now, back in the day, it used to be that nothing could get on Steam, and now everything gets on it. They've gone the complete opposite direction. They just open the floodgates to absolutely anything, and then this kind of thing is inevitable.
So has your favorite ASMR trivial platform been using 98% of your CPU load? Maybe something suspicious is going on there. Why don't you let us know what you think of this story down in the comment section below. Remember to like the video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe if you're new around here. There's more content on the screen here. There's also a link to our Patreon right there. Stick around for some more videos coming this week. See you next time. Bye-bye.